A government shutdown averted, but still much of the Biden agenda hangs in the balance, with Congress still negotiating the details. Today, my conversation with Indiana Congressman Larry Bucshon, plus Attorney General Todd Rokita on the president's vaccine mandates, and State House Minority Leader Phil Chiaquinta of Fort Wayne on the battle over redistricting. It's all ahead on this week's edition of In Focus.
Thanks for joining us today. I'm Dan Spieler. Every week we bring you the latest news and analysis of what's happening here in Indiana and in our nation's capital, where it was a busy week for lawmakers, avoiding a government shutdown and negotiating the specifics on some of the president's key agenda items.
The bill is passed.
The House and Senate passed the funding bill Thursday. If they hadn't, federal funding would have run out October 1st, and we would have been looking at a government shutdown. Congressman Andre Carson said this is good news for the millions of federal employees who could have been put out of work as well as their families, adding that he'll keep working to pass the Build Back Better plan, which Democrats have been negotiating here in recent days. I also spoke this week with Congressman Larry Bucshon, who says the government's current funding process needs to change.
I wish we didn't have to do that. We need to get our spending under control, but I think, you know, we're going to do the blocking and tackling of government. Primarily fund the government, I think probably, you know, not for the entire fiscal year, and I think your viewers will see that. But I do think that we will not have a government shutdown and we won't go there, at least this time. And I think the government will be open.
Is this a matter of kicking the can down the road once again? And why do we always seem to be back at this place, no matter which party is in charge?
Yeah, that's true, no matter which party. And the reason is because I think the budgeting process is broken. I think, you know, first of all, I think we need a balanced budget amendment to the Constitution to force the Congress to balance our budgets. Most states have that. That also has resulted in out of control spending. Honestly, both political parties, we've only balanced the budget maybe four times in the last 60 years. And we just can't get agreement between the two parties about what the priorities are. And we haven't really for decades. And you know, even if we can in the House, the last time the US Senate passed appropriations bills to then fund the government in a regular way has been many, many years. So the process is broken and the two parties really have pretty broad disagreements on the priorities. So we end up with these continuing resolutions funding the government based on previous agreements that we've made in the past. So that's the reason. I don't like it. It's not the right way to do it. But it's not up to people like me. It's up to our leadership on both sides to get control of this and to get a compromise where both parties can vote for it.
Infrastructure has been one issue where at some level the parties have been able to compromise. It's something you and other Republicans have talked about in terms of its importance. There was a bill that passed the Senate on the bipartisan basis in the House this past week, likely to have some impact here in Indiana. Are there aspects of this bill that you support? Is this essentially a protest vote against it?
No, I mean, I don't vote in protest of anything. I mean, there's reasons for why I support or don't support legislation. In this case, they've linked it, they did link it to their $3.5 trillion reconciliation bill, which I don't support because it's dramatic out of control spending and changing the social fabric of our country. So that's the reason the infrastructure bill has struggled. And the reason, you know, it's too bad because we do agree on infrastructure, as you pointed out, I think across party lines. I was on the infrastructure committee for a couple of terms. And we couldn't get an agreement. We were in the majority, Republicans. We couldn't get an agreement on a number of things. The biggest issue is how we fund it. The current bill doesn't put a lot into most of the priorities that I would have: roads, bridges, the airports, and rural broadband. And, you know, it has some funding in there for that, but a lot of it is for climate change related issues and honestly funding priorities in larger cities with transit that have already received tens of billions of dollars in the Democrats' American Rescue Plan. So we just can't come to an agreement.
Would this infrastructure bill, would it help cities like Evansville and Terre Haute in the end?
Well, more money always helps everybody, right? So that's the case. But if not done properly, you know, you find that the policy is the issue. You know, they may not get as much money as you would think, because a lot of the money is diverted to other, you know, priorities that are not related to the cities or towns or communities that I represent. A lot of it directed at large urban areas like Chicago, New York, and other places. Look, they need money too, don't get me wrong. But, you know, more money, sure, we could always use more money. But the reality is you also have to pay for these things.
Let's talk about the pandemic as well. Our numbers have been starting to crest and come down, but we're still seeing hospitals overwhelmed across the state. A number of hospitals, including Deaconess there in Evansville, now getting support from the National Guard. You've also posted graphics from Deaconess showing how the vast majority of COVID patients there are unvaccinated. One person on social media responded to you saying, "I get your point, but unfortunately your base doesn't want to hear it," in their words. Is that the problem here as you see it, base voters in your party who don't want to get the shot?
Well, I think what, you know, Republican voters don't like is mandates. They like individual choice and freedom. I was a doctor before. I think most of yours know that. I think people should get vaccinated. I think the data is pretty clear. I posted on my social media. Most people who are hospitalized in the intensive care unit or on a ventilator are unvaccinated. And statewide data just came out that shows that roughly 98% of people who have tragically died in the state from COVID are unvaccinated, based on data over the course of this year. So I support vaccination. I think it's safe and effective. But you know, I also support people making individual choice for themselves.
All right, more of that interview on our website. Speaking of those vaccine mandates, this week our Kristen Eskow spoke with the White House vaccination coordinator and with Indiana Attorney General Todd Rokita.
Individuals know how to take care of themselves and their families better than a government can.
Attorney General Todd Rokita says he's looking at ways to fight the Biden administration's COVID-19 mandates. Those include a vaccine requirement for many healthcare workers that would be issued by the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services, or CMS.
Does CMS, in your view, have the right to issue that kind of mandate?
No, I mean, I don't think they do. And look what it's causing. I mean, you have healthcare workers leaving.
But some healthcare systems and other companies say the vast majority of employees are complying with vaccine mandates. At Community Health Network, Dr. Robin Ledyard says more than 90% of employees are vaccinated, and less than 1% were terminated for not complying with the mandate.
Although we definitely lost less than 1% of our workforce based on the mandate, I think, you know, for other smaller hospitals or critical access hospitals, you know, losing 1% for them, or losing one person actually, and for all of us, can be detrimental.
When he was in town this week, the White House vaccinations coordinator told me he believes mandates work to get more people vaccinated, citing several examples of companies that already have mandates of their own.
Take some health systems like Kaiser Permanente that are over 90% now.
Dr. Shukir says vaccine mandates aren't the only way to get more people vaccinated, and says information and incentives have convinced some to get the shot. But he believes requirements make an impact.
We're going to have to keep doing everything we can to get this country vaccinated. This is our path to getting us past this pandemic.
From the Indiana State House, I'm Kristen Eskow.
Okay, Kristen, thanks.